And on. LeBron, three. Giannis grabs it, reeling it in.
Are you like this one?
Dark horse MVP. Oh, foul! Foul! That's a dark horse MVP right there.
And going right out of his teammate. Well, that was Booker on the foul. That was Booker on the foul. I thought that was LaVine.
We'll get around him. Boxes and elbows, make him shoot.
I think they're on a triangle and two on Curry. Right? I think they're playing a triangle and two. They don't want him, number one, to get the all-time all-star scoring record.
Team LeBron's first free throw tonight.
Oh, I haven't heard that since high school.
Triangle and two.
32-year-old DeMar DeRozan with an outstanding season for the Chicago Bulls, who have the same record as the number one team in the East, Miami.
Let's go, Book.
Tiebreaker puts Miami 1, Chicago 2. DeRozan, a huge reason why. With LaVine, who's on the floor.
Oh, what a pass.
Ball 3. Got it. LaMelo Ball.
Embiid is starting to get a little bit more votes from me for MVP as well if Team Durant ends up winning this.
Antetokounmpo over Booker.
They won.
That's what I love about Giannis. He's a two-time MVP, and he continues to improve his game.
He's got 28 tonight.
Look who wants it. The leading scorer in the league.
Get out of there.
I got him.
Defending Embiid. Chiseling inside. Tight defense right there. Picked up by Antetokounmpo.
And that's why Allen's in this ballgame. He's been doing that for Cleveland all season.
One of the best rim protectors in the league. Curry for the record. Allen's got it. Off to Curry. And Young is on him. Steph whittling his way down low. Missing the two. And Embiid is there. And picked up by Giannis.
That's what I'm talking about. The best pickup game in the world.
Three. Got a rebound by Embiid. Target score 163. Booker. Triple.
This looks like the highlights I watch on social media.
These gentlemen are playing right now. They are playing.
This looks like UCLA.
Yeah,
the highlights.
The men's gym.
Curry to Giannis. Flying, driving, cut it. Antetokounmpo contorting his body around the defense of Embiid. Ball. Booker outside, Young, three. And it's Giannis inside. 163 the target. There's LeBron James at the Portland picks. Getting it in up and two. Embiid took it. LeBron knocked it away. Giannis was there. The trolling James.
Man, this is thick in here. This is thick.
Booker. Threads one.
Go to Joel Embiid. Go at him.
Yeah, face him up. Chase him. Yeah, face him.
It's at six.
That is so good.
It does not crawl in. And Curry with 50 points to James. He's got 22. DeRozan.
You know what time it is.
Let me start isolation plays. This season in the NBA, number one in isolation plays and points. DeMar DeRozan showing it there. LaVine inside.
All he needs is a bucket. By any means necessary, all they need is a bucket for LeBron to go 5-0 in this format.
Curry, three for the win. He's now had a string of misses.
He better be careful.
LaVine, three.
There we go. Next bucket win.
This is what I'm talking about.
Next bucket win.
This is what I'm talking about. Look at LeBron calling for it, Reg.
And he is from Akron.
Let's do it.
Cleveland.
Let's do it in Cleveland. Cleveland!
This is for you.
Game-winning shot by LeBron James.
And a
It's a two-point game. Team Giannis on top, 15 to 157 points. But this is the setup of the 24-point fourth quarter. Wins the game. Here's Embiid back in his way on Davis, and he is fouled.
I love that right there, Embiid, not settling, taking his time, using that big body. So crafty, getting himself to the free throw line. Smart play by the big fella.
It's interesting how both teams really are guarding that three-point line now with the sense of urgency with the target score to 157.
Embiid is now 1 for 3 from the line.
A lot of missed free throws here in this fourth. Two by James Harden. Russell Westbrook missed a free throw. Embiid.
Team Giannis is 4 of 10 at the line. And we're staying right here. We are commercial free throughout the fourth quarter. And Team Giannis has a 3-point lead. But the key is getting to 157. Harden from the corner.
You knew he was due to make one, James Harden.
Making that three with a contest from Embiid.
Raised to 11 now.
So the tied at 146.
Raised to 11.
Giannis played by Harden. Giannis backing his way, has to give it up. Embiid. And a foul is called. And we're seeing players arguing fouls, which you rarely see in All-Star play.
Well, there's no Ole defense going on now. With a race to 11 here, the target score, 157.
And B is now 3 of 5 up the line. All his free throws have come in this fourth quarter.
And as you said it best just a while ago, the way these guys are closing out the three-point series, maximum effort here. You know what's on the line.
And both teams are going with their best lineup. There's no question about that throughout this fourth quarter. Team LeBron with LeBron James, Chris Paul, Anthony Davis, Kawhi Leonard, and James Harden. It is a 2-point lead for Team Giannis. Paul met on a stretch by Giannis. Leonard, that's a down low. Oh, gorgeous reverse by Anthony Davis.
May have gotten fouled on it as well.
And a foul is called right there as Lowry and Paul come together, and Chris Paul is upset.
So we're at the point in the game where you just can't gift guys going to the free throw line. And you've got a target score here.
Paul committed the foul.
Yeah, look at the complaining here to the officials. You can't tell me this is not mean something to these All-Stars.
They're complaining like it's a regular season.
Lowry 3 for 3 at the line. He's an 85% free throw shooter. Both of them
are as a foul.
Both teams are over the limit. Team Giannis is within 8 points of the target score, so we're now playing last two-minute rules. That means fouls and replay reviews. That comes into effect. Team Giannis up 150 to 148. Leonard with the pull-up. Yes.
I tell you, it's interesting, the play calling now, the sets. Frank Vogel getting the ball to Kawhi Leonard's hand these last few possessions.
We asked Frank earlier will there be any set plays. He said he has a couple. An inbounds and one over. Lowry played tightly by LeBron and rebounded by Davis.
Team LeBron with a chance to go ahead here.
Physically by Lowry. Davis for 3. Way off. And back comes Team Giannis. Led by Giannis. Looks to go all the way. Then throws back the other. Here's Walker for 3. Rebound Giannis. And Harden took a shot to the head.
Oh, so did Walker right there.
All right, here's LeBron. Setting it up. Davis.
Giannis with the stuff.
Team LeBron has taken a 152-150 lead to 5 points away from victory. Team Giannis 7 points away. Embiid backing a nice fake on the floor by Embiid. Wow.
Gave him the Hakeem Olajuwon shake. Both teams now 5 away from the win.
Gives it back. 152 apiece. James is trying to draw the foul. Does not. And here comes Giannis. James lost his balance. And it looks like Giannis had the ball knocked away and out of bounds.
So they're letting them play right here, Marvin. Look at this.
Ooh-wee.
And LeBron, a little no call right there.
No, he's got a foul. Mark Davis has a foul.
So it will be a jump ball. The Team LeBron challenge was successful. So no foul call. The really getting reports from the official scoring table that it was on Paul, it was on LeBron, it was on Davis.
And one time they had Queen Latifah with the foul too. So,
so Davis and Embiid jumping up. Game tied at 152. Both teams 5 points away from victory.
A successful challenge because now Team LeBron got the ball as well. Instead of Embiid shooting 2 free throws.
Leonard, played by Embiid, gets it out. Here's James with an angle three. Rebound Embiid. And Leonard took it away. His pass off the mark, but saved at midcourt by James.
What a save indeed.
Now remember, all these guys are used to being the alpha male on their teams. How do they share the ball?
Harden is fouled. Harden 0-for-2 at the line. Both free throws coming in this fourth quarter. Team LeBron is now 4 points away from victory. First to 157, which is called the target score. This time Harden hits both. Team LeBron 154, Team Giannis 152. Siakam, played by Harden. There's Siakam off the fake, and he is fouled by Harden.
Now, Reggie, if he makes both free throws here, is Team LeBron going to go for a three?
Yeah, now you got to guard the threes. They've been doing it.
Siakam making his first appearance at the line.
Here's a good thing. Do you foul, send them to the line, and let them make two just so you can get the ball back and go for a three at the other end? And then they may foul you and put them on the line.
I get the feeling that strategy in this, the first game of this type format, strategy is still being formulated. So he goes 1-for-2. And look at the crowd. Team LeBron with a chance to win here with a three. There's Harden getting the step. Kicks it out. Leonard, who's been red hot from 3-point range, not this time. Rebounded by Embiid. Team Giannis back in control. Oh, Walford lost it off his foot. Felt pressure from LeBron James and lost the dribble. So once again, Team LeBron,
they're going for the win.
Shot.
They're going for the win. From three.
All right, here's LeBron. Oh! Rejected. They want a goaltend. Well, it is successful block. Yes, it is. They'll jump it up.
No basket. And LeBron cannot believe it.
Ball to center court coming up. Team LeBron 154, Team Giannis 153.
How big was that missed free throw by Pascal Siakam?
So Anthony Davis and Giannis Antetokounmpo on this jump. Controlled by Team LeBron.
And they're going for the three again. The captain's guarding one another.
Fires from center court.
He was going for it. He was going
for
it.
I'm not mad at him.
So Walker back for Team Giannis. Now played by Hart. Gets a pick. For the roll as Giannis ends up down low against LeBron. Here's Lowry on a fade. And Team LeBron back in possession. And again with a chance to win it with a three. Hart, no foul called. And now we get a call. He hits the call. Look at that. A late call. Team LeBron has outscored Team Giannis 30-20 in this fourth quarter. And Team Giannis has come right back. Walker watched by Leonard. And we get a whistle away from the ball.
Oh, offensive
foul.
Wow. They call it on Kyle Lowry.
That's, it is on Lowry, his third.
Yes.
And back.
Yes.
That's the correct call. A John Stockton screen right there.
That's the correct call.
Back comes Team LeBron again, needing a three for the win. LeBron played by Walker. Spins away.
But that's okay.
That was a foul.
That's okay. You're still in the game if you're Team Giannis. But you absolutely have to get a basket and a stop. You can't even foul because you can't send them to the free throw line either. You just need a bucket right here.
And here's Siakam going in the middle of work, going out of Harden. And the ball is deflected out of bounds. And last touch by Team Giannis. Team LeBron, they can win it right here.
And fitting LeBron James going against Giannis Antetokounmpo for the win.
Pick set by Paul. Now Paul played by Walker. Five on the shot clock. Here's Paul for the win. Chased down by Lowry. Walker looking for a three. Embiid backing James. Embiid takes him down low, lost his footing, may have traveled.
We got a call. Foul on LeBron.
Embiid is 4 of 6 at the line.
Do they have another stop in them, though? And you can't foul and send him to the free throw line. First to 157. Play defense without fouling. How many times have you heard that from coaches, man? Can you play defense without fouling?
So Leonard will throw in Siakam on the inbounds. Looking for Davis. Gets to Harden. Harden back the other way. Here's Paul for LeBron.
Didn't Harden have a layup?
He had the shot. Did. LeBron played by Giannis.
Captains guarding one another.
There's a pass to Davis. We got a whistle. A foul is called. So Davis to the line. He can win it.
Oh!
This is on the first.
Wait a minute.
It's not over yet.
Wait a minute. You have got to be kidding me.
A pressure free throw for Davis.
And now you got to box out, too. You've got to box out, too. Are you kidding me?
Oh, Team LeBron has won it. 17 for the Greek Freak. 21 for Damian Lillard. He's been hitting a three in 16.
I like the pride here being shown by some of these players about wanting to win this ball game. This is bragging rights as well.
Irving for three.
2 minutes.
With just under two to go in the fourth quarter. Embiid played by LeBron.
Too easy.
Yeah, able to take him right to the rim.
Well, is Team LeBron going to have to make an adjustment? They're playing LeBron at the center right now. He can play guard through center, but Embiid having his way in that painted area on offense.
See, this is where LeBron has the advantage now with Embiid trying to guard him out on the floor.
For free and hits.
Right there.
LeBron
right back
James
at you.
From downtown has tied it at 144.
LeBron James trying to go for his third All-Star MVP.
Team Steph going right back at him to their advantage in the post.
Embiid had it knocked away.
Ooh, that went off Embiid's foot.
Let's see what the call is.
Oh, they're going to take a look at it because this may be off Embiid's foot.
You see the double team, though, automatically Durant saw that he had the mismatch on LeBron. Durant automatically went over there for a double team trying to get the turnover.
So they go to the replay review. Here's another look.
Did it hit Durant's right foot?
The angles in Secaucus.
Oh my goodness. They're giving it back to Team Stephen.
Oh.
You can see LeBron is upset. Kyrie Irving is upset. Kyrie is saying, look, Reggie says that it should be their ball. He's look using you as the reference point.
Here it is. It's off of Embiid's foot. It's off Embiid's foot. Does it touch anyone else? No.
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 Oh, no.
No. It does not.
So a minute and 16 remaining, 9 on the shot clock. And then Harden takes the inbounds.
Well, clearly they didn't take Heinz's view from the baseline.
Harden fires and comes up short. Deflected out of bounds. With 0.3 remaining on the clock.
0.3 seconds.
And a timeout is going to be taken by Mike D'Antoni.
That's why we had to make the call.
Well, watch for a back screen for Embiid for that tip-in or guide-in, as you were mentioning, Marv.
And that's the Kupo spinning inside.
Curry will inbound. There it is. The tip missed on the follow by Embiid, and the ball snatched by Westbrook, met by the Harden. 1 minute remaining. Game is tied.
They're going for the mismatch of whoever Embiid is guarding.
George puts the move on Embiid.
What a block.
And the follow is missed.
Oh, man. What a block by Embiid.
And George in a collision with DeRozan with 40 seconds to go. Back in L.A., Team Stephen with a one-point lead over Team LeBron. 40 seconds to play. It'll be Team LeBron. And LeBron himself in possession will throw in from side court.
Interesting. Mike D'Antoni taking off Joel Embiid.
Westbrook putting moves on DeRozan. And to LeBron, he scores. And his club wins by one. Harden. Played by Westbrook. Fires for three. Rebounded by DeRozan. Another possession, a 4-second differential. DeRozan guarded by Irving. DeRozan on the drive, and his pass too strong went through the hands of Adetokounmpo. So Team LeBron with the 1 point lead, 16.7 remaining,
got a foul.
And they have possession. Westbrook gets ahead of the field, and he scores.
This is why Steph drafted so many three-point shooters. Even with Embiid out on the floor now, you have to guard everyone honestly. And if you get past your man, you can expect to find a wide-open guy waiting for it in the, behind the three-point line that can knock it down.
If your team, LeBron James, switch everything, and yes, that includes with Joel Embiid.
Communicate.
Team Stephen does not have a timeout. Team LeBron has one timeout. Neither called a shot well from three-point range. Now to 5 seconds. Curry looking for the three. Curry double team. Curry can't find it. Now does, and that will do it. And Team LeBron off the bench. A happy group.
You know, when you look at Dirk Nowitzki's stats on the year, he only had 41 made threes this year. He was upwards of over two a game, as we see LeBron lay the ball in. But he really has gone away from the three-point shot.
Shooting only 29% from beyond the three-point line. And Avery Johnson actually had tried to pull him back from shooting threes. Here's Nowitzki to the rim. And the game is tied at 1-16.
Well, that's where he wants him, down that mid-post area where he can get to the rim and get to the free throw line more often.
Coming up on 4 minutes to play in the fourth. Wade had nowhere to go, and the West comes up with it. Byron Scott staying with Chris Paul at the point in these final minutes. Try to get it down low, and a foul. A loose ball foul is called. It's on the East. Foul on Howard, that's his third.
You know, you talk about the shoes with Steve Nash. You look out there, Reggie. Everybody broke out their shoe for this this event. It's amazing where sneakers have come in the last 20 years.
Well, listening to LeBron James, even the officials, as he kind of got on Eddie Rush, Eddie Rush is calling his Air Tars.
Now Duncan working the post, facing a double, gets it back out to Paul. They swing it. Nowitzki. And Wade is on it. And here's Wade to the rim, and he's turned back. Stoudemire, yes, and the foul, as he was shoved, was able to get it up, and he's headed to the line.
Amari Stoudemire getting it done at both ends of the floor. He denies Dwayne Wade at one end, runs the floor, and gets the end one. Dwayne Wade thinks he has an easy alley to the rim right there. Amari Stoudemire out of nowhere.
Foul on Howard, that's his fourth. So Stoudemire looking for his 19th point as he gets set to shoot the free throw.
You know, Amari takes a lot of stuff about his defense in Phoenix. He's the sixth leading shot blocker in the NBA. So you put him with Shaq in there now, I think it's even going to enhance his ability to guard that rim.
Here's Allen from way downtown. Ray Allen with a three to give the East a one-point lead. Allen off the bench for 17. Paul, yes. How about Chris Paul? What a performance. 13 points along with 12 assists. So the West back up by one. Here comes Paul on the open floor. Has Roy. Brandon Roy, who's played well, has not been looking for his shot, but he's done a good job in distributing the ball.
Now Chris Paul's changed his whole game since he's come in.
The West with its biggest lead up by three with 2:35 left in the fourth. Paul defending on James once again. Allen with another deep three and scores.
Ray Allen from long distance, keeping this East squad in the ball game, tying it up, back-to-back threes.
That's his fourth three of the night. We are approaching 2 minutes to go in the fourth. Paul for three, rebounded by Wade. Allen open for three, yes!
Ooh. He is smoking.
In fuego.
125-122. The East on top. 23 points for the Boston Celtics. Ray Allen, nine have come here in the fourth on the three-pointers. He hit the three threes over the last minute 16. He's 5 of 8 for the game. Overall, 23 points. He scored the last nine for the East, the All-Star Game record for most threes. Mark Price hit 6 back in 93. Allen with 5. A minute 45 left in this fourth quarter. And the West in possession trailing by 3. That is deflected away. Last touch by Wade, and the West with 6 on the shot clock.
Well, it's interesting. The East looks like they're in a zone, and they're trapping the post now. They're going back and double-teaming the post. So you're seeing some defensive scheming here now.
Well, LeBron James is guarding as Chris Paul laces up a 3.
So the game is tied at 125 with a minute and a half to go in the fourth quarter. And here's Allen looking for 6. Rebounded by Duncan. Chris Paul now 16 points, 9 in the fourth quarter, along with 13 assists. He's in the MVP discussion. They double up on Duncan. Shot clock to 4. Wild pass attempted by Nowitzki, and it's picked off. So back comes LeBron with a minute to play in the fourth. He goes all the way!
Woo!
LeBron James with that change of pace move to give the East a 2-point lead. James has 27. Nowitzki, Paul charged for an offensive foul.
Yeah, he actually wiped out the defender when he handed that ball off to Dirk Nowitzki. This play is spectacular. Remember, Amari Stoudemire had gotten a block in there recently. Not this time. As he hands his ball, he just wipes out Ray Allen.
And this has developed into one of the best finishes in All-Star Game history. 35 seconds left. Here's Wade. Yes, and the foul. The East up by 4 with 35 seconds to go in the fourth, and Wade is headed to the line.
Well, LeBron James got it done in the previous play, and now Dwayne Wade comes down in the teeth of the defense. Brandon Roy all over him. You saw him make that and one before over his shoulder. Degree of difficulty.
Dwayne Wade, a 76% free throw shooter. Not able to complete the 3-point play.
He has not shot them well in the fourth quarter this year.
Half minute remaining. Nowitzki has a 3-point shot blocked by Wade. Recovered by Paul. He fires for 3. It's tipped and missed. And back comes Kidd. Allen takes all the way. With 15 seconds to go, it's a 131-125 lead for the East. Time running out on the West. Roy for 3. With 8.7 to go, the East lead is down to 3. Kidd inbounds, has Allen, and he is fouled by Paul to stop the clock. And we would like to point out, guys, that the polls are still open. Remember to vote for the All-Star Game MVP by logging on to NBA.com or texting the player's last name to 38657. 38657. Ray Allen, one of the league's best free throw shooters, 91% at the line. He's among the leaders. Ray Allen, a late add to the All-Star squad, replacing the injured Caron Butler of Washington, has 26 points. 12 have come in the last 3 minutes.
And when I talked to Doc Rivers a couple weeks ago, he said he's still trying to learn to incorporate Ray Allen into their offense there. Well, today he found a way to do it. And Ray Allen got hot at the right time, and it looks like the East is going to pull this one out.
Down to 6 seconds to go. That was last touch by the West. And now substitution. Chauncey Billups will come on for Dwight Howard. Howard with 16 points, 9 rebounds.
Doc Rivers got all these really good free throw shooters out there.
Kidd with the inbounds. He knocked it in off Nowitzki's foot and then was able to get to it as a foul is called. Stop the clock with 1.8 remaining. And the West is over the foul limit. So Allen to the line. Foul by Paul. A moment ago, Ray Allen missed a free throw, which is most unusual.
Yeah, he's missed two tonight. Right,
very uncharacteristic of Ray.
And Ray Allen, a leading contender for Most Valuable Player honors.
You like him, Coach?
I voted early and often.
And from the body language, the indication is that Doug, who had a vote, went for Ray Allen.
I did. I thought he changed the game. I thought Chris Paul, had they won, would have gotten my vote because of what he did to get his team back in the game. But Ray Allen's electric shooting, we'll see if the other people agree with me, but I thought he changed the game with those brilliant shots. Larry Brown was the East Coast, the Eastern coach, and he traded for Mutombo right after that game, and they went to the NBA Finals. So it's funny how impressions last in moments like that.
Right here, the East up by six, Iverson. And back comes Bryant. Avery Johnson hoping that Kobe Bryant or Tracy McGrady can catch fire and get the West going. Here's McGrady, 4-3. And Iverson able to run it down. The West gets back. Gilbert Arenas, 4-3. Rebounded by Yao Ming. Bryant passed on the three and lost it. James knocked it aside, recovered by Bryant.
Did you see him get that ball back? I can't believe he recovered that.
Duncan had it slapped away. Last touch by the East, and the West has four on the shot clock. Now Dwayne Wade will come on for Gilbert Arenas. Gilbert not able to get going, 0 for 4 in his 10 minutes.
Yeah, I expected him to play well today, Marv. He struggled last year, and he said he was a little nervous. He is coming off a 4 for 20 night, though, the other night in Dallas.
McGrady rimming out, rebounded by Ben Wallace. Eastern squad with Iverson and Wade now at the guards, and Wade off the bench and immediately knocks it down. The East 115, the West 107. Here's Bryant, 4-3, way off, rebounded by Ben Wallace. Iverson with that skip dribble goes behind the back, but Ben Wallace could not handle that strong pass.
See if the West will go into Yao Ming. Nobody's even looking at him out here.
Well, Bryant did, but hit him right in the forehead. Not what he had in mind. Let's go to David Aldridge.
Vince, you were on that team in 2001 that made the big comeback in the East. 16 points, fourth quarter, great crowd in Washington. How'd this game turn around?
We just felt like we didn't bring the energy early, and we wanted to give the crowds a show, but they wanted to win in the beginning, so we decided to come out. We're just going to play hard and see what happens in the fourth.
Those Pistons are pretty good defensively, aren't they?
Yeah, they got a few years together.
You play with this young fellow over here, Bosch. What's his future looking like?
I think he has a very bright future. He deserves everything he's gotten. He deserves to be here. And he's one of the best big men in this league right now. And that's why he's my man, and I'm proud of him.
Thanks very much, Fitz. Back to you, Marv.
All right, thank you, David. Things getting heated here between Kobe Bryant and LeBron James.
A little shove looked like from Kobe, trying to fend off LeBron.
Iverson and James with the finish. LeBron James has had a sensational game, 27 points, 11 of 19 from the field, and the East now leads by 10. Foul is called. It is on Ben Wallace.
Remember, this play sort of happened before where LeBron picked Kobe. He got the ball back. This time you see the little shove there by Kobe. Things getting very competitive here, and this is what you expect in the last 10 minutes of the fourth quarter. A little circus shot by Allen Iverson, and there is LeBron James. He has been fabulous.
Nash got the step. McGrady, he is fouled.
You know what's amazing to me, Marv, is with LeBron James out there right now with Rasheed Wallace and Ben Wallace, the West cannot get to the basket. They have totally shut the lane down. Everything has been a contested shot, either a three-pointer. And it just shows you the power of that defense. And LeBron James right now is taking the challenge defensively to go with the two Wallaces. And the West can't get to the basket.
Evan McGrady, 1 of 6 at the line. Tracy McGrady at the line. As I mentioned, 1 of 6 from the foul line. He has not been able to recapture the touch that we saw earlier in the game.
He is 3 of 8 from the three-point line. The rest of his teammates are 0 for 15.
James changed his mind, finding Ben Wallace, and he's pushed by Dirk Nowitzki. And that puts the West over the foul limit. And Ben Wallace will go to the line where he has shot 45% during the regular season. Now look at the high point men. Tracy McGrady with 31. Uh-oh. Then with the air ball in his first attempt. Tim Duncan with 15. LeBron James led the way for the East, 27 points, 11 of 19 from the field. Strong game for Dwayne Wade, 8 of 10, 18 points. And how about Chauncey Billups, 15 points, 7 assists in 16 minutes. And he and his Piston teammates sparked the East in this come-from-behind effort. They were down by as many as 21, and now McGrady knocks down a three, and you never know if McGrady is able to catch fire, and we have all seen that on a number of occasions. 117-111, the East with the six-point advantage. Iverson. Here comes Nash. Nowitzki. Double-teamed and fouled by Wallace. So the East also over the foul limit.
Well, you start thinking about MVP at this stage of the game, and you've got to think that if the West can somehow pull out this comeback victory, Tracy McGrady, the obvious choice. On the East side, certainly looks like LeBron James would be your favorite if they hang on to win.
Remember now the All-Star record is what, 42 points? Tracy McGrady with 34, still 2.5 minutes to go in this game. That's still plenty of time for him to get into the 40s, and especially if the game could go into overtime, we might see a record here in front of his home crowd.
Well, Marv and I were here the night that he scored 13 in about 34 seconds in this building against San Antonio, so we know he can do it in a hurry.
Good job by Brand getting to that rebound, but not able to hit on the jumper. The last time a player from a losing squad won the MVP is LeBron James, with a spectacular move, was able to hang and twist his way to the rim.
That was shocking.
That was the best move of the game.
Here's the alley-oop. And Tracy McGrady now with 36 points. It's a 5-point East lead. The last time that a player on a losing team in the All-Star game took the MVP award, 1990, was Magic Johnson. Won MVP honors. Here's Rasheed Wallace stepping back for three. Kobe Bryant very quiet tonight, just 2 of 8 from the field. McGrady using the screen, shoots for three. Rebounded by Nowitzki.
Shaq's got to cover Nowitzki here right now. If they run a pick and roll or something, he can fade out and maybe get a three.
Nice pass from Bryant. Broken up, though, by Wade. He's able to slap it away from Brand.
Well, we ran the screen and roll, but O'Neal just stayed with Nowitzki.
He stayed attached to
him. He doesn't want to give up that three. That means there's going to be some openings in the paint.
And as I mentioned a moment ago, Bryant just 2 of 8 from the field. 25 minutes of play. Does have 8 assists. And 6 rebounds. Kobe trying to free himself up. He does. And he fires over Wade and comes up short. Nowitzki on the follow. Wayne Wade all over Kobe Bryant. That was the design play, as Craig just told us. But Kobe had very little room to operate. It's a 3-point East lead, and a foul is called. Both teams are over the limit. Foul on Bryant. That is number 5. Let's take another look at that move by LeBron James.
Marv, I talked about the power. Look at him as he takes his ball, slices between two players off the glass with his left hand. I mean, he made it look so easy when you're sitting here and you see the speed and the grace of that move.
All right, here's Iverson. An 80% free throw shooter looking for his 13th point. He had 1 point at halftime. And now looking for number 13. So the East up 121-116 with a minute remaining. Here's Bryant to the rim. Kobe Bryant able to get the step on Dwayne Wade. It's a 2-point East lead, and we're down to 50 seconds left in the fourth. Wallace trying to set the pick. James shoots for three.
I don't like that shot in those circumstances.
Here's Bryant protecting the dribble. Took his eye off it for a moment. Deflected out by Iverson. 37 seconds remaining in the fourth. Avery Johnson telling his guys, take a quick shot. That's exactly what Kobe Bryant does.
Can I take my best move of the game back? Did you see him split two guys? I think he took the ball between his legs.
Between his legs backwards, just like Avery Johnson drew it up.
Yeah, oh yeah, good coaching there.
Game is tied at 120. Here is Iverson coming up short. Wade, and the East leads by two with 16 and 6/10 seconds remaining in the fourth. Timeout called. Doug, in an all-star game, do you go for a three for the game?
I do. I run it out here, see if I can get me a three to win the game and stuff. These players don't want to probably stay here and play overtime anyway. Roll the dice and go for the win.
Well, and since you're in Houston and Tracy McGrady's really the only guy who's been consistently making threes tonight, I think you go right to T-Mac here.
And I know Kobe's chomping at the bit to take this last shot, too.
All right.
T-Mac going to isolate here.
All right, McGrady played by James. McGrady. That was deflected short, kept alive by Bryant, and stolen by Rasheed Wallace, and that will do it. Here's Iverson putting off the glass, and again the scuff is missed by Vince Carter, but the East has come away with the victory.
What if he would have missed that dunk and would have bounced back to a guy for a 3-point shot?
Incidentally, Alonzo celebrated his 31st birthday this past night. Fans over at the jam session here in town.
You know, Marv, I was with him most of the summer when he was over playing in the Olympics, and I, you know, I had no idea at all that he was sick, and you couldn't see it in the way he played or the way he practiced, the way he came to do things every day. But I will tell you this, as we were with him most of the summer, I got to see such a different side of him. We see the warrior, we see his competitiveness, but I got to see a gentle spirit and a really great guy. We all wish him well. Get back out as soon as possible.
Yes. Here's Allen, able to finish in the East in the midst of a run. So they cut it down to 14 with 7:45 remaining in the fourth quarter. Johnson Morning also recently donated $50,000 to the foundation that Dikembe Mutombo has set up. Dikembe now halfway to his goal of raising $15 million to build that 300-bed hospital. Target to break ground in September. 7-0 run by the East. Gary Payton sits down, replaced by Jason Kidd. 5 on the shot clock. Michael Finley just took a shot from Allen Iverson. Both shaken up. Here's Stackhouse. Jerry Stackhouse of the Detroit Pistons, averaging 29 a game. That's number 3 in scoring in the NBA. That's a 9-0 run off the 2 by Stackhouse. And it's now 95-83. The West lead is 12.
You can see right now the East really scrambling, helping each other out on defense. Mutombo inside, changing the shots. And if they can do this and get out and run, still plenty of time to get back in this game.
Iverson met by Robinson, had to pull it back. Here's Allen.
That would have been bigger. That would have cut to 8.
To put a move on Ray Allen. Here's David Robinson. And bottle up and foul. Foul number 4 on Mutombo. Reminder, next Sunday, starting at 12 noon Eastern, a star-studded NBA triple-header coming your way. Allen Iverson, Vince Carter, Carmelo, Chris Webber, and much, much more leading the way, and then capping it all off in the nightcap. It's Kobe and the Lakers going up against Reggie Miller and the Pacers. That's next Sunday. Triple header starting 12 noon Eastern time. And a reminder, join TBS this coming Tuesday night. The Sacramento Kings travel to Salt Lake City to face the Utah Jazz. That's an 8 o'clock Eastern start. So it's now an 11-1 run off the bucket by Carter. 13 points for Carter. 96-85. The West with the lead coming up on 6 minutes to go in the fourth. Robinson has 8 points.
Just to follow up on that King Jazz game, Carmelo went to Rick Allen and he says, Coach, he said, you don't have to play anymore the rest of the day. Let these younger guys play. They played their first game out, so Rick Allen said, fine. So Carmelo will not play anymore today.
Friendly.
It's going to be
the ball. Put home by the dice. There's Carmelo. He
NBA's greatest power forward of all time. Two-time MVP, MVP of the 89 All-Star game, and most valuable player back in 93. Tim sharing the honors last year with Shaq. 24 points, 14 rebounds last season. That's a three for Stackhouse. And the West leading out 100 to 90. How about Timmy Mitchell? 19 rebounds in 23 minutes. Here's Kidd. And his rebound number 20. The last player with 20 rebounds in an All-Star game. Charles Barkley with 21 and 19-91. 100-93. The East hanging around. Carter now has 16 points.
Look at the level of the defense start to pick up now. The game is in the balance. Both teams want to win.
And they lost it. Recovered by Robinson. And he's fouled. For the East, Carter 16, 15 apiece for Iverson. And Allen Duncan leading the way with 14. Bryant with 13. Kobe posting on Barbary. Here comes Iverson. Bryant. It's only a 7-point game with 4.5 to go. Iverson, does he get the continuation? Yes, he does. It counts in the foul. And it's fouled for a 5-point West lead.
I love this, the fact that it got down to this point in the game. 5 minutes to go. The game is in the balance. You're going to see the competitive nature of every one of these players now surface. Allen Iverson with the great drive to finish, the opportunity now for a 3-point play, which he gets. It's now a 4-point game. And Mark, the difference is, after 15 turnovers in the first half, the East had only 5 here in the second. That's why they're back in this game.
It's a 22-5 run by the East. What a job by Dikembe Mutombo. Put him on the MVP candidate list. It's 21 rebounds for Mutombo, and Larry Brown wants to talk it over. All right, the East with 4 seconds to get it across, but the shot clock running down with no problem at all, no pressure at all from the West. And then a foul is called. It's on Bryant, 4-11, remaining in the fourth quarter. A couple of aspects at stake, the game and MVP honors. You see Duncan, 14-12, Mutombo, 21 rebounds. Iverson to the line with the West over the foul limit. The all-time All-Star game record, most rebounds in a single game, held by Bob Pettit of the old St. Louis Hawks. He had 27 in the All-Star game back in 1962. At the time of the top right now, that's 21.
The game is on now, Mark. The game is on.
It's a 2-point game with the East in possession. Carter putting the ball back right there. Carter could not put it down.
There, trying to get that back too quickly. Got to get good shots now.
Kidd and Bryant in the backcourt. Duncan, Weber, and Garnett up front. Duncan stopped by the Mutombo and a foul. And the crowd reacts. That's number 5 on Dikembe.
Dikembe has changed this whole game. He's now guarding Duncan. You don't have to help out. So if they're going to go to him, Mutombo's got him locked up down there. Rebounding, his shot blocking. He is giving his team a chance to win this game now.
Here's the double on Bryant. Mutombo altered that shot. Here comes Iverson. Kidd is back. Iverson. Rebound to Brady. And the game is tied at 100. And this crowd is now very much into it.
Yes,
the West by 2.
It's going to be very difficult for them to go to Duncan because they're being played by Mutombo. So they could go to Garnett, who's being played by McGrady, or maybe Weber, who's being played by Carter.
Iverson for 3. Allen Iverson will often have bad shooting games, but he'll come up and hit the big shots. He hit a big one here. The East up by 1. The first time they've led, Kidd for 3. Kidd able to keep it alive. 2:25 remaining on the board. Bryant. Kobe able to recover. Now that's a dangerous pass. Duncan is out of there. Here's Weber. Yes, a full possession. What happened, Marv, in that situation? The East were leaking out to try to run. You've got to first get the rebound. The tumble's telling his teammate, somebody's got to help me in here.
West is led by as many as 21. Nice pass. Potter, try to get it back. Here comes Kidd. Anderson with the steal, but he stepped out of bounds. Adam Anderson with 13 on his 23 points in the fourth quarter.
You can see why Larry Brown loves this guy. Watch him, comes from nowhere, tries to tightrope along that sideline. And Marvin, you said it so perfectly a while ago as he steps out of bounds. The other night in the Garden, he was having a horrible shooting night. Hit, I think, two or three shots late to win that game. He will keep attacking you.
In that game, he hit three straight from downtown. Potter with the steal. Iverson on the run. Iverson gets it off. Calls the foul.
Well, the East has hurt all year long. The West is better. The West is deeper. The West has got all the big players. You know what? Right now, it's a tie game. Iverson has a chance to put his team in the lead. So this is a big game for them. They want to show, don't discount the Eastern Conference.
Iverson, 82% free throw shooter. So the East takes a one-point lead. A minute 35 remaining in the fourth quarter. Bryant being chased. Bryant able to hit. Marlboro chased him down. But Bryant still hit. And the West up by one. Stephon Marlboro handling against Jason Kidd. And wants a timeout. It is Eastern Conference ball. 1:15 left in the fourth. Carter for three. Vince Carter having his difficulties down the stretch.
So he's got to play with Kevin Garnett with a hand in his face. Kevin Garnett, 6'11", with that long reach, so he's not going to get any easy shots.
Bryant, yes, Kobe Bryant with two clutch buckets. He now has 17. The West leads by three. Marbury for three, yes.
Kobe Bryant wants the ball once again. He's made the last two baskets. They double him and force him to give it up. Jason Kidd might have to shoot the ball here as Iverson is just leaving him wide open.
Bryant.
Oh, that is unbelievable. Mutombo ran out at him. Three unbelievable shots in a row here by Kobe Bryant.
A stirring finish to this 50th NBA All-Star game. The West by two. Marbury for three. Again. Stephon given the East a one-point lead. 25 seconds to go. In the fourth quarter, Kobe Bryant has scored the last 6 points for the West. Here's the double on Kobe.
They have a foul to give. The East does. If they let this wind down, they can take a foul.
3 second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. There's the foul given by Marbury. Well, still 10 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter, but here are the results of the NBA.com polling for most valuable player. We were talking about guys from the West earlier, but the East turning it around, coming back from a 21-point deficit. So Allen Iverson leading the way. How about Stephon Marbury with the clutch shooting down the stretch, along with Kobe Bryant?
Well, now with Jason Kidd staying on the floor, it'll be interesting to see if Iverson runs off of him, goes to Kobe, forces Kobe to pass, and maybe make Jason Kidd take the shot.
And here's Kidd. He's up by one. Out of five. Marbury guarding Bryant. Out of three. Marbury trying to get to Bryant. Duncan came up short. It's over. The East comes from 21 down to defeat the West. They outscore the West 31-21 in the fourth quarter.
Wish you were here, Bird and Johnson. Well, Magic's here, but not in uniform. We're glad he's with us. And it's a rare time a Celtic and a Laker are not in the All-Star game. It's never happened before. There's always been usually both, but one or the other represented.
And I don't think it'll happen again. both franchises are great franchises.
Reggie Lewis, many thought he should have been.
No question about it. But both franchises are down right now, but they'll be back.
Stockton
to Barkley, to Malone. Olajuwon might have gotten away with a push, or was it Barkley? Has anyone played better, any superstar in this league played better to this point with so little publicity than Olajuwon?
No. No, he's done it. And you know what? He hasn't worried about that contract situation or the owner argument that they had last season. He's played over all that and just having a tremendous season.
115-110, time running out. 70 seconds to go. 75. Jordan banks one home. It's a three-point game.
Well, this guy's used to big finishes in this building, isn't he?
Yes.
23 for number 23. Olajuwon stripped of the ball by Isaiah.
Now, you don't need a three right now, do you, Magic?
No, you don't need a three. You have plenty of time to get a deuce, come back down and play good defense again.
Marley hawking Jordan. Rebound Malone to Marley. Oh, almost a mistake by the West. And it's Malone inside, and they love that in Salt Lake.
Well, if Pat Riley should decide he wants to go for the three-pointer here, he might take a quick two off the dribble. But you have Mark Price, who's eighth best in the league behind the three-point line, and Dumars is on the bench, who's 13th best.
Price is 5 for 7. And hits the three. What a game for him. And the foul by Jordan on Marley to stop the clock. 117-115. Just under 26 seconds to go.
It's almost too bad that you can't give out two MVPs. It's just like last season, last year's game, that Clyde Drexler could have been the MVP as well. It's a shame. And this year, same thing could happen.
Marley misses. So even if he makes a second shot, the East is a three-pointer away from a tie.
Now, Michael is over there talking to Pat Riley, and what they're talking about is whether or not they should bring it up and try and go for a shot in transition, or whether they want to take a timeout and advance the basketball.
Yeah, it's going to be an interesting call to see what he actually wants to do here.
I think he'll take the timeout and advance it.
Marley gives the West a three-point lead, and indeed Riley has called time and to set up a play with 25.9 seconds left. Tough getting it in.
Well, a little bit of confusion there. Was it going to be a 5-second call, or were they going to give the timeout to the East before the 5-second violation took place? Pat Riley's laughing because he's the guy who was calling the timeout. West is taking the man off the ball. Watch for Pippen stepping back in for a shot after he passes it in back.
Right into Jordan. The quick shot, and he makes it. That's your call, Magic.
Yes.
And
yes.
Now let's see about the quick foul.
Yes.
Timeout West.
They got a big man Pippen on the basketball right now, trying to take away that long touchdown pass, trying to cause him problems getting it in.
In the corner, and all alone is Hardaway. What a play by Price. He committed the foul. It looked as if he might have gotten the ball. Hardaway has not missed, as you can see, 8 for 8 from the line.
Now, I don't think they're going to call a timeout.
So it's a two-point game, 119-117, with 16.7 seconds left. 24-second clock off as the East looks for a tying and perhaps a winning play.
And the last two times, they've had a problem getting the ball inbounds. I'm talking about the East team. It has not been easy. The West has done a good job of zoning up areas and taking cutters coming to the ball out of their routes.
Jordan with Marley. Ewing is open. 8.1 seconds. 119-119. Marley will inbound the ball with Jordan on him. Now Jordan backs off and will double team the inbounds man. Stockton knocked away by Ewing. Out of bounds to the West.
Now here will come the problem in an All-Star game, because no timeout, so now what's going to happen? Who's going to get the ball here?
Barkley. Hardaway. Over
my. I got you a fan.
So things tightening up east and west, and a rally by the east orchestrated by Pat Riley.
And I was involved in that last one in 87 where Rolando Blackman got fouled with no time on the clock. He went up there and hit two free throws to send it in overtime.
In fact, it was Isaiah Thomas who walked up into his face before the foul shot, said a little something to try and distract him. Blackman knocked them both down.
Shaq O'Neal comes in. The East was never ahead that entire fourth quarter, but managed to tie.
Hey, what's going to happen now with this MVP voting, huh?
There's a rumor going around. Oh, new sheets are being handed out. So it's going to start all over again.
Yes.
Stockton on Isaiah. Malone underneath. Taken away, and Jordan to Marlin. Barkley passes up on the three. 5 minute overtime period. Ooh, Thomas gets thrown down by Malone.
Pick and roll situation set up that time.
Foul was on Ewing of the East, his third.
Before you call.
We'll have both big men in there, Ewing and Shaquille, so it'll be interesting to see what happens here.
Malone gets away from Ewing.
Well, I think he's a little too quick for Patrick. Patrick's not used to playing a quick power four. He's used to playing centers who's a little bit slower than Karl Malone.
Now Ewing's turn. Oh, a tough 10-footer.
Patrick is used to doing that. Turn the baseline, shoot that jumper.
11 points for Ewing.
This is why this is the All-Star game. You get to see the best perform at their best.
Jordan around Robinson, who does a little dozy-do, and around you go to save the 2 points.
Robinson did the right thing, fouling before he got into that lane.
1 minute gone in the overtime period. Jordan playing, remember, with 5 fouls. And he gives the East the lead, 123-121, 27 for Jordan.
Isaiah's smart enough to know to give the ball to the right people and get out of the way, and they're going to make something good happen.
Well, Isaiah wants to win. Isaiah wants to win. He understands that Michael just do his thing.
Barkley against Pippen. Marley, a three-pointer. And Marley gives the West the lead, 124-123.
He's making Michael Jordan pay for cheating. You can't go double-team Charles Barkley with Michael Jordan, or that's what you'll get right there.
Shaq O'Neal. Robinson rebounds, and O'Neal fouls him.
Well, Shaquille was just disappointed that he got that close, basically overpowered the post position, and then just playing Mr. Layup. But Michael Jordan with the basketball, now he gives a little show, and then let me step underneath and just kiss it off the front of the rim and hope to get a nice little roll.
The West by one, and Stockton goes the distance. The West by three.
Oh, Barkley stepping right back in on the inbounds pass. If you rush out of bounds, you don't concentrate. Smart defensive player takes a shot at it. That's what happens.
Barkley and Ewing. And it was O'Neal made the block.
Everybody trying to get a little piece of Charles down below right there. Sends a big fell to the ground.
They're playing hard. The winner gets $5,000. The loser, $3,000. That's pocket change, tip money for these guys. But they're playing for competitive pride. Well, Malone misses both.
Ooh.
It remains a three-point lead. 2:35 to go.
I might get Mark Price up and get him ready right now.
Jordan to Isaiah for two. Ewing. Patrick Ewing. 126-125. The West with the lead in the ball. 13 points for Ewing.
Now, when
Stockton left alone.
They've been running the same play over and over. Just that pick and roll. They might use different men, but it's the same play for the West.
2 minutes.
And now the East is going to give their version of the pick and roll.
Less than 2 minutes to go. Ewing over Robinson. Robinson got a piece of it. Barkley embraces the rebound.
Well, that time when he screened and stepped back, it was much deeper than the previous times. Before it was a 16-foot jumper. That time a 21-foot jumper.
Four Olympians in white for the West on the floor now.
Stockton to Barkley for three. Taken away by Malone. Stolen by Pippen. What a reaction by Scottie Pippen. Ewing. What a steal by Pippen. No wonder he's all NBA defense. Riley with Ewing and Shaquille on the floor, and Westfall has his big guy Barkley along with Marlon.
I wonder if they've changed their defense on the pick and roll. They might try. There it is. They're out trapping, trying to get the ball out of his hands.
Less than a minute. Barkley stolen by Michael.
Good pick by Isaiah.
To Pippen and a foul. Robinson reaching in. 50 seconds to go. A 4-point deficit facing the East. Jordan trying to cut that in half. Shaquille. Stockton. And timeout called by Stockton, who is pinned in.
And with that team they have out there, especially you're talking about Pippen, Jordan, and Isaiah, they could come up with a steal. And also Shaquille can get in that passing lane.
Ewing too. So they got some good defensive players out there in blue. Foul Pippen on Marley. Chance to build the West lead to 6 with 35.5 seconds left.
Marley, pretty good free throw shooter, 77% for the regular season.
Paul Westfall's players here in overtime. Marley and Barkley imposing on the East. Now it's going to take a couple of trays for Riley's Eastern team to tie it. That's an all-star record for Price. Good exterior defense. Jordan with 28 seconds.
Oh, line drive. How do you shoot a three? Going to your left, fading out of bounds. Defensive player on, you're getting smacked a little bit and still knocking down.
Because he's Michael Jordan.
30 points for Jordan.
Yeah, well, Riley said, let's go through Michael Jordan. They certainly did here. Hand in the back, a little bit of a push, fade him to the baseline, in the hole.
Jordan, who has the highest scoring average in All-Star history, 21. Listen, I'm going this way with you, Michael, right this way.
You know, it's interesting to see that Pat Riley is pulling for him and his teammate so hard today, and then tomorrow they're at war.
They meet in the Eastern Conference Finals, he will be pulling for.
There you go.
Hardaway needs one of these two. Uh-oh. To give the West a 4-point lead.
And there goes Isaiah talking to him. Isaiah's chatting with him.
Somebody better make sure they box out in case it's a long rebound. Isaiah may be on the line instead of Mark Price in this situation.
Hardaway is now 9 for 11. Oh, my. Ewing with a rebound. Here comes Price. Plenty of time.
They're going to flow into now the shot attempt.
Oh. Stolen by Stockton and then almost taken back, but a foul.
Good move by John Stockton. Good defense.
13.5 seconds. 3-point lead. David Robinson is 5 for 8 from the line. So three straight misses here in the final seconds by the West. And Mark Price goes over and Pippen says something to Robinson.
Well, they double-teamed him that time. Put a lot of stuff in his ear.
Yeah.
Robinson's 20th point gives the West a 4-point lead, 134-130. All right, snapper, 4-point advantage. Pippen will inbound the ball from the near sidelines. To Price, forcing the three. Robinson rebounds, and that should do it. 9.2 seconds.
Well, that time when Price came up open, but he stumbled when the ball was coming to him, and he couldn't regain his balance, and too bad. Because he had a good look, and he was open.
It's so difficult to get the ball inbounds from a side out in the NBA because of the great athletes, because the defenses are so good, and the, you know, the coaching in the timeouts is normally so good during the season. That's why the execution becomes so important. It's inches, when you're coming off the screen, where the ball is passed, and a little stumble that time cost them.
You know, and when I played in All-Star games and the game was tight, sometimes you wonder, what, you know, these guys all are the go-to guys on their team. And I wonder how Michael felt when the play wasn't designed for him.
Scottie Pippen throws the three. Batted out by Stockton with 3.6 seconds. 5-point deficit staring at the East. Certainly made it a battle. Weren't a lot of loose smiles around. You saw Mark Price just moments ago. That's the kind of smile you saw a lot of in most All-Star games, but not today. It was tense. Co-MVPs, you got your wish. 1993 All-Star MVPs, John Stockton and Karl Malone. A Utah Jazz parley. And Michael Jordan will be the next man to re-enter the ball game, and so will Dominique Wilkins. And here they come. Going out, Jeff Malone and Kevin McHale.
Return for the East. Replacing Jeff Malone.
4:42 remaining in the fourth period.
Well, let me tell you, there's some interesting stuff going on right now. They're trying to keep Dominique. Will probably try and stay with Worthy. But Larry Bird is going to have to beef up against Tom Chambers. So the rebound advantage may have turned in the favor of the West.
They need all the help they can get, trailing the East by 7. Thomas guarded by Blackman. Chambers on Bird, as you mentioned. Wilkins and Worthy matched up. They try to double up on Moses Malone. And Akeem gets another big rebound. And now the West trying to cut it to 5. Rolando Blackman does just that.
When you defensive rebound and you get the good outlet pass, they're within striking distance.
But a pass to Moses Malone. From Isaiah Thomas, gets two back in a hurry. Chambers scores for the West. And it's blistering action now in the All-Star game. Thomas for the East.
Well, they're trying to wear each other out. Here's Magic coming back.
132-125, Akeem. He's got it. Olajuwon finds Chambers, and he's fouled. 132-125 with 3:46 to go. A chance to cut it to 5. McHale comes back in.
Kevin McHale replaces Larry
and Bird goes out. He has scored 14 points. Malone with 23, Moses that is the leading scorer for the East. Chambers has 26 for the West.
Well, that move was to give the East another move, another low post option. McHale for Bird.
Nearly a steal by Magic. Michael Jordan controlling. 132-127. Last touch by Malone, and it's West ball. And this crowd very much in this game. And a chance to come back. It was a 12-point lead for the East. Akeem. And it's now a 4-point game. 3-point, 132-129.
Well, Magic is making it happen. He's penetrating, and he's putting the ball on the glass, or he's passing it off.
And the West has Blackman and Worthy, and Magic Johnson, Chambers, and Olajuwon. 133 and 17 on the shot clock.
Watch him go for Moses.
Bird, top of the key, wide open. Rebound, Olajuwon. And again, the West can take the lead, but Jordan nearly snuff that one out. The East by 1. 13 on the shot clock. Magic. Chambers blocked by McHale into the hands of Bird. And the West misses an opportunity to take the lead there. McHale. And Blackman can't get it down court. Now Magic with 49 seconds. Magic. And Akeem is pushed out of bounds, and he'll go to the free throw line.
And he can make the big play either way for you.
Akeem is 5 for 7 at the line, and we have a tie game at 136. Hey, what do you leave?
Now it will fall on the shoulders of Michael Jordan, more than likely, to run the show for the East.
And the West leads. 45 seconds to go. The East has one timeout. Julius gives the East the lead, 138-137. What high drama in the final minute of this game. Timeout called by Pat Riley.
Both Chambers and Blackman, good outside shooters.
And Julius playing all over Chambers. Blackman watched closely by McHale. They got enough time on the clock. Blackman puts it up and he's hit on the arm by McHale. He's 8 of 9 from the free throw line. Rolando Blackman, who has scored 22 points and an 88% free throw shooter during the regular year. That'll tie the game, and there are 24 seconds remaining. So the East could have the final possession, and the East is out of timeouts. They used their last timeout.
And I don't think they wanted to call that timeout before Blackman took the second free throw. I think somebody made a mistake there.
He misses. The score is tied. And now the East, with no timeouts, can use the rest of this clock to try to work their way for the winning points. It's 138 all. Thomas. 10 seconds. Isaiah blocked by Akeem. McHale, fall away. It's good. The basket counts.
They're taking Moses on the inbound man, trying to force it way out.
And Blackman. A foul is called with no time remaining. And Rolando Blackman is going to go to the free throw line with no time remaining. 9 of 11 from the line is Blackman. He needs to make both. Minutes. We're all tied at 140. It'll be Elijah Wan and Moses Malone jumping. Akeem has 5 personal fouls. Worthy controls for the West. He finds Blackman.
Boy, and he was standing there for about a 5 count before Worthy found him.
Blackman has 27 points. Moses posting up Akeem. No, nearly tied the game up. Magic coming down with it. 4-on-3, Worthy.
As the fast break in action, get the ball quickly up the court. You put all kinds of heat on the defense.
The two Lakers that time. 144-140. Bird inside, fouled as Isaiah Thomas thread the needle again. 2 shots for Larry Bird. Bird looking for his 16th point of the game. Keep in mind that the East has won all 3 previous overtime games, including that 1984 affair in Denver. 2-point game, West in front. Thomas, Magic.
The West has a great man to go to now, is Kareem.
Chambers with the follow-up. Magic drove and Chambers with 32.
Well, Magic saying, I'm going to do it one way or the other. I'm either going to pass for it or score it myself.
Jordan has a screen from Bird. Bird now posting up away from the hoop. Thomas has Moses Malone, double team. Good defense by the West. Bird, foul. So he's in danger of being disqualified.
But, you know, at a certain point in the ball game, as we look at Wilkins come in, Dick, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar is a creator, too, on a set offense. If you get the ball to him and they start double-teaming him, he'll find the open man, too.
146-144, the West, off the screen, Blackman.
That Riley's enjoying it, right?
29 points. He wants the win. No more Mr. Nice Guy, said Pat yesterday. Jordan. Malone tips it in. Moses now with 27 points. Interesting, in the East lineup, they really have only one guard in there, in Michael Jordan. It's Bird, McHale, Moses Malone, and Wilkins along with Jordan. Kareem, skyhook, in and out. And it hit the stanchion underneath. Let's see who touched it last.
Well, that's not a bad guy to go to in your set offense, because he's been in these situations before, Kareem, and he's either going to get the shot or he's going to find the open man.
Under 3 minutes to go, 148-146 the West. Chambers gets two more.
Now Magic says the pick and roll play, Chambers is setting such a good pick that Magic's getting right into the teeth of the defense, making McHale adjust.
34 now for Chambers. Whistle and a foul. So it's Wilkins, Jordan, Irving, Moses Malone, and Larry Bird. A smaller lineup, if you will. Bird for three, short, air ball. But there's Moses. No foul. And Moses is elbowed down by Kareem. Let's see who they call it on. Foul was on Wilkins. 4-point lead for the West with 2:14 to play. Overtime, Kareem.
That's the man I'd be going to down a stretch if I was the West.
And a timeout, 2:02 remaining. All sorts of heroes, and it's going to be very difficult to pick an MVP in this game.
2 minutes.
Under two minutes to go in overtime. The doctor hits, and it's 152-148 in favor of the West.
Boy, Dr. J has come into his own with that outside shot this past season.
22 points in this game. Moses on Kareem. There's the hook. Kicked out to Worthy. New clock.
No double teeing on Kareem. He'll take the shot. You double him, somebody will get an open one.
Minute and a half remaining in overtime. Chambers. Kareem and Worthy. James Worthy gets the basket. And he has 22.
And the East does not have enough rebounding people in there to help Moses Malone on the board.
Out of bounds, East ball. Robert Parrish.
McHale on the bench. Lambeer on the bench. Moses has had to do all the rebounding.
Highest scoring game in All-Star history. Malone did everything but get the basket. And the West in control now as we wind down to a minute to go. 154-148.
Watch this pick and roll again.
Magic looking for Chambers, who didn't roll. Here's Magic. Out of bounds, West ball. He fouled out Akeem Olajuwon. Kareem has come up and picked up the slack.
The only other big guy to help on that pick and roll play on the boards is Larry Bird, and he's been switching out to take Magic Johnson, so Moses had to do all the rebounding by himself.
18 rebounds for Malone, the most since Dave Collins cleared 20 back in the 1972 game. Under a half a minute and 4 seconds on the clock. Blackman didn't have enough on the drive, and now the East coming back. Dominique Wilkins. We'll go to the line and shoot a pair.
Wilkins.
Of beating the East in the All-Star game as Wilkins misses the first free throw. The last time the West won was 2 years ago in Indianapolis.
I got it.
Kareem will inbound. Magic gets it to Kareem. 10 seconds. 5. And they foul in desperation with 5 seconds to go.
I tell you, I love to watch Magic play in an All-Star game. You know, he may never win an MVP award, Magic Johnson, but he creates all the great things that happen for his teammates in this game.
Final seconds. Pat Riley will have his second All-Star victory in overtime. Final score, the West 154, the East 149. What a game, Tommy.
This is a great show and a great competitive battle. The East had won four in a row from 63 to 66, trying to make it five straight. Kiki Vandeweghe has hit two in a row. And we'll have a foul against Lane Beer. He was holding Kareem inside.
Well, if you don't get that good pop-out stuff, look back into the inside guy and ask Kareem, as Lambeer laying muscle on Kareem, lots of muscle on Kareem, and whistle did blow.
That's the fifth team foul, so it's the penalty, and Kareem is shooting two. Kareem, leading scorer for the West, 21 points today. This is 13th All-Star appearance. Higher record.
Yours.
He was selected for a 14th back in 73, but was injured and didn't play.
Well, it's still anybody's ball game.
Sure is. 4-point game, 135 remaining. Isaiah Thomas guarded by Ricky Green. And they're going to call the West.
Little strategy move here by the East team. Lambeer, with that good outside shooting, is pulling Kareem out and allows Doc to perhaps isolate somebody inside, and that's what the East has been trying to do, is get Doc one-on-one down low.
Julius with two. Now going for his 28th point of the game. He was the MVP last year. He had also won the Most Valuable Player Award in 1977. Bob Pettit won three, shared another time. Oscar Robertson won three, Bob Cousy won two. Those are the multiple MVP award winners. 6-point lead, Magic Johnson feeds to Sigma. And it's a 4-point game again. 132 to 128, 118 to go. Julius to Larry Bird. They're gonna use the clock.
They sure were, and Bird really had a chance to get an outside shot, thought better of it.
105 and 9 on the shot clock. Julius Erving against Kiki Vandeweghe. Julius Erving misses. Kareem the rebound. Can they cut it to two? Here's Magic. And it's thrown away. Let's see, it was deflected. And it's going to be West ball. Julius Erving has 28 points in the game. He's the high scorer. And that's the most points in an All-Star game since George Gervin scored 34 4 years ago.
That's impressive, but Lambeer has been impressive. Isaiah Thomas has been impressive. And somebody better be impressive for the West.
Sigma. He's been impressive today.
He sure has.
On the follow-up, and it's a two-point game. The West has three timeouts plus a 20. They've got plenty of time there. Thomas against Green. Bird, top of the key. Kareem the rebound. The West can tie it up. Magic Johnson. He doesn't.
The East are going to end up with the last shot.
There are 2 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Timeout. Listen to him.
So they got Larry Bird and Dr. J. A
lot of rebounders. It's Thomas and Erving and three big guys. 13 seconds. Tie game at 132. Bird fakes. Fires it up. 4 seconds to go. Here's Magic Johnson. Fires it up. Overtime.
Good matchups coming up here for both teams to potentially try and take advantage of. Robert Parrish maybe against Jabbar. Jabbar against Parrish. And we've got Dr. J guarding Kiki Vandeweghe. And the Iceman being guarded by Andrew Toney.
Here is Kiki Vandeweghe. Julius falls down. Vandeweghe is open. And Vandeweghe in and out. Parrish. The rebound, and the East can draw first blood in overtime. Isaiah Thomas, it goes and it counts. Isaiah Thomas, 18 points, all in the second half. 14 assists, and a 3-point lead for the East here. Keep in mind, on the fourth foul, you get the bonus. Each team allowed 2 timeouts. The West also will have a 22nd timeout. That's a lot of them. He did not use it in the fourth quarter. Thomas didn't have control of it, and Sigma is fouled as he gets the rebound. Isaiah Thomas just didn't have control.
And he could have probably laid it off to Andrew Toney that time, who might have had an easier chance to try and score, but he's trying to make it happen. Isaiah Thomas,
George Gervin, a scoring machine in the backcourt, looking for Sigma. Bird is on Sigma. Here's Jack Sigma, tipped up and in by Kareem. And it's a one-point lead for the East with 1 minute gone by now in overtime. This is the third overtime in the history of the All-Star Games and the first one since the East won in 1980 in Landover, Maryland. Bird looking for help. Andrew Toney. Notice they have the good outside shooters in there now.
They sure do.
Julius.
And there's one of them. Medium range jumper, and that's pretty decent range for Dr. J.
30 points for Julius Erving. George Gervin. One-hander. And an offensive foul called against George Gervin. He used that left arm.
Great defensive play by Andrew Toney to destroy the rhythm of the Iceman.
137, 134 the East, 3:20 to go. 19 on the shot clock.
Here's where you have problems. When you get down to the last couple of minutes of a key game like this where you don't have the coordination, the execution of set plays. So there might be a lot of one-on-one like you're going to see maybe right here.
Bird, baseline, blocked by Magic Johnson. But Julius is there. Irving, 32 for the Doctor. And a five-point lead for the East. They're opening it up now. Gervin got free inside.
Magic Johnson knowing where the open man was.
20 assists for Magic Johnson today.
Well, we're going to need a computer to keep track of those.
Three-point lead for the East. Toney. Andrew Toney. So the Philadelphia 76ers are contributing heavily in this overtime effort. Julius Erving has 4 points. Isaiah Thomas, 3, and Andrew Toney with a basket. 141-136. Gervin blocked by Toney. 2-on-1. Thomas and Toney. Here's Andrew. And a foul. Basket counts. 8 points in the game, but he got the key hoops. The last two, and now it's a 144-136 game. The East is leading, but 2:25 to go. We're in overtime.
And as we saw in regulation, anything can happen with a few minutes to go in an All-Star game.
Vandeweghe guarded by Erving and is held.
Six.
That's on Julius Erving. And that is the second team foul in overtime. There's the West bench, a little more solemn.
Yes. Even the happy man, Frank Layden, can't cheer him up right now.
Kareem, skyhook. Rebound, Parrish looking down court. He's got Toney. Here's Andrew. Andrew Toney.
That was a super outlet pass by Robert Parrish and a great reception by Toney.
He's got 7 in overtime. And the West comes right back with George Gervin. But it's 146-138 and under 2 minutes to go, as you see. Most points in the history of the All-Star game. Two teams, you're seeing it right here. Julius Erving adds 2 more.
You turn a guy like Dr. J loose in an All-Star game because there's really no team defense again. Double teams, when the double team, that turns him virtually loose one-on-one.
10-point lead, cut to 8 is Kareem with 25 in the ball game. Makes it 8 points now, 148-140, the highest scoring All-Star game in history. Today here in Denver.
Well, where else should it happen but in Denver?
For the East, Andrew Toney and Julius Erving have scored 13 of their 16 points in overtime. The Philadelphia connection in this case, 111 to go, an 8-point lead. The West needs baskets, good defense, and breaks. There's one, and here comes Magic. Still enough time, down by 8, Vandeweghe inside. Johnson, Magic Johnson on the follow-up, under a minute to play. And a 6-point lead for the East. Double team Bird. And a foul. Vandeweghe and Johnson all over Larry Bird and a foul. And that's not a bad move.
Well, they're going to have to do it with good defense, the West. If a steal, if they could have made a steal, so much the better. But if not, go foul. The East will have to take the ball out of bounds.
Second team foul or third team foul on the West. One more and they're in the penalty. In the overtime. We're in the overtime period with 45 seconds, 16 on the shot clock. 6-point lead for the East. Knocked away into Bird's hand. Parrish. Inside, Thomas. Isaiah Thomas got it. A big basket for the East.
Boy, and he put it up there among the lumber.
21 points in the second half. Johnson for three. A three-pointer for Magic Johnson. Coming right back, Parrish, the other end. And doesn't he run Kareem in the regular season, Parrish?
Every single time he can, Dick.
Magic for three. No. Bird. 20 seconds to go. And the East is going to win this one. Five in a row. Tony.
Well, that's some great individual play. Isaiah Thomas, Dr. J, Lambeer.
And I'll tell you something. We have a million heroes in this game, and you're looking at one right now, Isaiah Thomas, who is a brilliant player. Isaiah Thomas is our most valuable player of this All-Star game. The final score here in Denver, Colorado, the East 154, the West 145.
422, 14 now against the West. Mirovic gets inside and passes it back out to McAdoo. Here's Rudy T, rolls up a hook that's off the mark. But there is the doctor. He has come on, hasn't he?
The doctor has gotten him back in this game.
Look at the doctor at the other end. How did he get back on the defense? Oh, and here is McAdoo. 115, 150.
Well, the doctor's got the back in the game defensively as well as offensively.
2-point lead. Lanier slides in.
I wouldn't be surprised Gene Shue will insert Elvin Hayes. Of course, McAdoo is playing so well, but strength-wise against Lanier, there's no comparison. And if they do keep going in low to Bob, he's such a fine offensive ball player. McAdoo will have no choice either to let him shoot it or foul.
West ahead by five on that free throw. We'll see as Mirovic,
you got it, Bob.
Could not reduce it. You could hear Barry say, "You got it, Lanier," and he did as he pulled out. Bounce pass now to Rick inside. Off of Collins, and ooh, he and Westfall collided. Paul really took a shot there on the chins. He okay?
Before we forget it, Brent, we ought to thank the people here in Milwaukee, how wonderful they were. And the hospitality, they really rolled out the red carpet for the players and everyone connected with CBS.
Oh, it's super, isn't it? All these great restaurants, Mater's, Sally's, the banquet last night. We got a terrific time. Barry now, back to Lanier, outside. There's that touch, the Detroit Pistons center. 120 to 113, 315 now for the game. Here's the doctor inside. Oh, give it to him and send him to the free throw line.
Great pass here by Mirovic. Julius going up. I don't know how he made it. I don't think he knows either.
27 points for Dr. J. Julius Erving.
We have some ball game right here.
4-point West lead and 3:05. Westfall looks in on Collins and goes right Barry. And here wants it. McAdoo fronted him. So Barry puts it down and drives baseline. Wisely used the defensive man to get the ball back out of bounds. There is McAdoo, what we're talking about. See how he's battling Lanier? That's the pressure on McAdoo. Because of the injury to Collins. Short of centers on the East team. Rudy T gives it to Mirovic. Oh, showtime to the doctor.
There's my MVP right there.
118 and 240.
What they're going to do is run a pick and roll with Barry and Lanier. And the thing about Rick Barry in this type of play, he's the best in basketball at executing the pick and roll.
All right, they're setting up now. Lanier and McAdoo. McAdoo jumps out on him. So Barry springs free. And they're fronting Lanier. McAdoo took it away. Barry comes in. Now the East coming back with a chance to tie it. Mirovic collided with Westfall offense. Great position by Paul Westfall of the Phoenix Suns. With 2:22 to go, he has forced a key turnover. Now West comes back. Let's set their lineup for you. Bill Smith and Rick Barry of Golden State. David Thompson of Denver. Also got Bob Lanier of Detroit. Westfall. Good play at both ends by Westfall. It's a 4-point West lead. Now 2 minutes left for the game, and there's going to be another timeout. Collins will inbound it. He'll set the play now. East trailing by two field goals. Slides off the pick, and Lanier went with him, and Lanier rebounded. Now the West can go up by six.
McAdoo should have hit the offensive board on that play because he had Smith on him.
Ah! For Lanier. Collision with Tom Janovich. You can hear the groan. Now Pistol Pete comes back. Pull-up jump shot. 2 points. 122-120 and 132 to go.
Pistol couldn't believe he missed that last jump shot, so he had to come back and make one for it.
Shot was short, and McAdoo controls the defensive board. Maravich quickly now to the doctor. Julius waits for Pete to set it up. 113 for the ball game. McAdoo, and there was contact. Lanier was outside on him. He was in the act of shooting. Now a chance to tie this All-Star game up as Kareem Abdul-Jabbar replaces Bob Lanier for the West with 109 remaining.
Going back to the other end, all the pressure's on McAdoo. How does he play Kareem? Is he going to front him? Is he going to play behind him and force him to shoot the jump shot? He's got everything riding on his shoulders at this point.
McAdoo has tied it at the line, and now as Billy Cunningham points out, it's all pressure time for McAdoo as he goes down on Kareem. Forwards will help out. There's Tom Janovich over. Open man, Berry on the end. Julius is over there, no foul. Here comes McAdoo now. 3-on-2. McAdoo can't put these to head, and Smith was fouled on the loose ball. 52 seconds to play. Still tied.
He rushed that shot.
Tie is broken. Timeout has been taken again. They set the strategy here. 52 seconds, 123-122 now. The West leading by a point. Collision, and Smith goes down. Back up. Maravich against Westfall. Slides, and Bobby Jones to the block. Battle for the loose ball. Berry gets it off. Here's Westfall. With 35 seconds, slams it home. And it's 125-122. 3-point lead. East comes right back. McAdoo comes up, and a pushing foul is called. East coach Gene Hsu checking with Jack McMahon.
Get out.
Now 125-123, a field goal apart.
The reason Thompson came in for Jones at this point is they're going to the other end with 33 seconds to go, and they want a more effective offensive player in there.
West leading by that point, Billy. Timeout has been called by Larry Brown with 26 ticks of the clock left, 17 seconds on the shot clock, and 26 seconds for the game. Knocked away by McAdoo. East now with a chance to win it. Inside of 20 seconds, and Bob McAdoo with the key defensive play. And as we've said all game long, all that pressure has been on him. 16 ticks of the clock, and you heard Strom tell Hsu 9 seconds to get it across, but no trouble, no pressure. Here's Maravich, slide inside of 10, right side is open, Westfall is there. Westfall, off now to Berry. West is going to break the losing streak. Berry will run the clock out, it's over. 125-124. The West has done it. Paul Westfall at that end, battling Pistol Pete Maravich. The East could not get the shot away.
As John Havlicek goes to the free throw line for the East team, check the East lineup. Dave DeBuscher, JoJo White, Dave Collins, Walt Frazier. For the West, Jerry West, Spencer Haywood, Wilt Chamberlain, Oscar Robertson, and Cassie Russell. John Havlicek totals 9, 4:20 to go in a ball game. West leads 103-96. Oscar Robertson and Jerry West, the backcourt men. Bill Sharman coached, Western All-Star.
Clear, Dave.
Spencer Haywood puts it up. And Jerry West comes out of there with it. 5 rebounds for Jerry West. Oscar, Walt Frazier. Back to Haywood. Blocked, taken away by Dave DeBuscher.
That was an outstanding defensive play.
Andy, somebody
He's played good defense on that sequence. Real good defense.
White. In and out. Rebound. Dave DeBuscher. JoJo. Leaves it off to Walt. Worked hard for it. Can't get it down. Slap it out. Whistle. Loose ball foul called on somebody.
Dave Cowens.
Dave Cowens. Four personal fouls. They are in the bonus situation, so they march to the other end of the court. Dave Cowens shaking his head, and Wilt Chamberlain heading for the free throw line. Wilt Chamberlain with 8 points and 2 out of 6 from the free throw line. Yes, Bill?
I think it's interesting to note in the last quarter here, the East team has 9 team fouls and the West team has 14 fouls. And the way you get into the foul trouble, you get the other team in the foul trouble, that is, you have to go to the bucket and, you know, penetrate. And then you get the other team in foul trouble early. And then every foul hurts them.
Well, Wilt missed 2. He's 2 for 8 from the free throw line. Jerry West comes up with another steal. That's 5 times he's stolen the ball tonight.
You see, the reason he's only got 5, he hadn't played the whole game. If he played the whole game like he usually does for Lakers, he'd have his 10.
That's probably very true. But they do not score. And the East comes back. And Jerry comes up with number 6. Dave Cowens. And West scores. 9 points. 6 steals. Ball got away, but DeBuscher picked it up and dropped it through. Any comments, Bill, on why Wilt Chamberlain's gone the fourth quarter?
Why
Wilt Chamberlain has played most of the quarter instead of Kareem Jabbar?
Well, I think Wilt is much better defensively. And I think that in order to break a game open, you got to stop the other guys. Not only do you have to score, but you got to stop the other guys. And Sherman has guys out there that can score for him. And so by putting Wilt in the middle there, he can slow down the other guys and make them take that outside shot, which is not a good percentage shot.
Okay, Wilt Chamberlain on a loose ball foul. That's his first personal of the ball game, the 5th team foul on the West. And Billy Cunningham will go to the free throw line to shoot for the East. We have 2 minutes and 25 seconds to play in the ball game. And part of the crowd of 17,505 now beginning to stir around a little bit. Billy Cunningham with 12 points. He has 10 rebounds. Missed the first free throw. And time called by the East team with only 2:25 left to play at the 22nd annual NBA All-Star Game. Our score, West 105, East 98. On the free throw line will be Billy Cunningham of the Philadelphia 76ers, right there.
He's going to give him a break. He's going to shoot this one left-handed.
He missed it. Rebound cleared by Dave Cowens and Oscar Robertson, trying to steal the ball away. Dave Cowan, 15 rebounds in the ball game, and Oscar gets dabbed with a foul, number 1, the Milwaukee Bucks for the West. The East team, Dave DeBuscher, Billy Cunningham, Dave Cowens, John Havlicek, and Walt Frazier. For the West, it's Haywood, Chamberlain, Robertson, West, Russell, and Cowens makes the first free throw. Game is not over at all. 105-99. We've got 2:24 to play. The East hits 100. It's a 5-point West lead. 105-100. And Cassie Russell trying to get out of backcourt. Billy Cunningham pressing it. Cassie's got room. Cowan, 16 rebounds. Walt Frazier up court for the East. Cunningham almost lost it to West. Billy drives and a foul.
That's what he's got to do. That was a good play. See, he went by the bucket and he went under to make Chamberlain have to go through the backboard, so to speak, or through the rim in order to block it. But that's what they got to do. So you can pick up fouls that way or either a good shot.
And for Wilt, that's his second personal foul. 2:03 to go in the game, and Cunningham makes the first one. It's now a 4-point West lead. Well, for a moment it looked almost comfortable. But now it does not look comfortable at all. Only a 3-point lead, 105-102. And the East pressing. Russell gets the inbounds play. Here's Oscar trying to get it up against John Havlicek. West leads by three. We go inside 2 minutes at 1:55 to play. Oscar trying to take it all away, and coming from the back door, Billy Cunningham. Havlicek was there. Who got the foul? Billy Cunningham. And for Billy, that's four. There he is. He was a big man on campus at Chapel Hill in those collegiate days.
You know, this guy, Oscar, has been in, this is 12th All-Star game, and he's been on 10 winning teams so far. I wonder if he's got anything to do with it.
He's played on a lot of winning teams in a lot of places, that fella. He makes the first free throw and gives the West a four-point lead. Yes, he'll get the bonus shot. Three to make two. East has committed 10 fouls here in the fourth quarter. Got a lot of them early. Oh, he missed two out of the three. So the East with the ball as Walt Frazier comes out of there trailing by 4 points in a minute and 45 to play. Jerry West after him. Havlicek, top of the key. Now the West leads by only two. And the East pressing full court. Robertson against Havlicek. Minute and a half to play in a ball game. A two-point West lead. East leads in the series 14 to 7. Jerry West with the ball, has room. And the Los Angeles crowd thunders their appreciation of Jerry West, 11 points. And it's a four-point West lead at 1:15 to go in the game. Frazier had to get rid of it, and Havlicek saved it. A good defensive play by West, forcing Walt to do that. West almost stole it again, but Havlicek scores. So the East fights back and trails by only two with a minute and 2 seconds to play in the game. They're serious.
Those
now.
Four guys you see right there are four of the greatest players to ever play this game. Havlicek, West, Frazier, and Oscar.
Oscar go all the way, but a whistle stopped it before the shot. Oscar on the line, 47 seconds to play in the game. And he knocks the first one through. There's Tommy. Boy, he was a competitor, wasn't he?
Definitely.
Still is. Oscar makes two. And it's a four-point lead, and time is called with 47 seconds to play in the ball game. The East will send out Billy Cunningham, Walt Frazier, John Havlicek, Dave Cowens, and Dave DeBuscher. Here's a shot by Havlicek. It's a two-point West lead. It comes inside to Jerry West. Now Oscar, Wilt Chamberlain, Cassie Russell, and Spencer Haywood. That's been the combination that Bill Sharman elected to go with here in the final moments of the ball game. 25 seconds to play. Cassie Russell, the Golden State Warriors. Short off the front rim. They had to shoot it. Here comes Frazier. The East could tie it. 13 seconds. Cunningham drives. Dave Cowens is first time. Cowens hit the bucket. And we're tied at 110. And time is called with 11 seconds to play.
Now, if West is taken out, I try to make it tough for Oscar to get the ball. So they'll probably have to give it to Cassie Russell. He'll probably go toward half court. Might set a pick for Oscar.
It comes to Oscar, and it's almost stolen by Frazier. Knocked out of bounds. They use 2 seconds. 9 seconds to play.
They still got to go to the front court. Now you're going to have Jerry West probably get it, and he's going to try to go all the way, most likely.
8 seconds. 6, 5, 4, 3. 2 points. It's over!
You can see that coming. You know he's going to get the two. But the game's not over yet.
It's not over. One tick of the clock left. DeBuscher will play it in.
I was going to say DeBuscher, but since he's taken out of bounds.
It may be Cowens. He may try to get away from Wilt.
I think Wilt will follow him out now.
Stolen by Russell. The ball game is over. So Jerry West, who hit the basket with 1 second to go to win it, for the West. 112 to 110 is the most valuable player in the ball game.